Okay, I'm going to address iOS 14 for you, how this affects Facebook ads, how this affects you as an advertiser, you as a business owner, you as an entrepreneur. Okay? If you are very reliant on paid advertising, for example, I think you should watch this video. Okay? I run a lot of paid traffic. I basically get I run paid traffic agency, right? And we help people run paid traffic. And I'll be honest with you, I'm very worried for small businesses. Purely because iOS 14, right? Like Apple has basically taken all of the data away from a lot of people. Okay, if you have run ads before, you also know that iOS people generally spend more than Android people. Like it's a fact. It's a $1,000 iPhone. The fact that you can afford a $1,000 iPhone means that you can spend money, generally. Okay, so like Apple's influence over digital advertising is very, very strong. Okay, so people think as well that it's only a Facebook problem. Let me go to Pinterest, let me go to TikTok, whatever. Okay? Sorry to tell you as well, right? Like they did it for everybody. Okay? They pulled data from every app. Okay? So they didn't care whether it's Facebook, Pinterest, TikTok, stuff like, you know what I mean? It's like every digital advertising platform that collects data based on behaviors. Basically, they removed that. They completely removed that. So we can't target. There's less lookalike audiences, custom audiences. They are less effective now. Okay, broad interest, right? Their audience sizes are much smaller now, purely because Facebook has less data on them. And so like all of these things, right, are going to affect advertisers, like 100%. Okay, and I'm a Facebook marketing partner, like our agency. So they send us like announcements, they tell us things internally basically. And like they are very clear that hey guys, this stuff is going to affect your performance. This is gonna affect ROAS. It's 1,000%. Okay. So if like the faster you just swallow that reality and move on with life, okay, the faster that we can you can solve this problem for yourself. Okay? So if you're selling anything online, right, what should you do? Okay? Facebook ads is like your ROAS is gonna decrease 1,000%. Okay? So should we diversify? Should we make better ads? Should we make better whatever? Okay? What I recommend is that a few things, right? So I feel should have a stronger emphasis on email marketing. So the retention, the back end, the LTV stuff is gonna be more important than ever. Okay, if you're not doing this, then I don't know what you're doing. Okay, that's number one. Okay, but the front end, where are we gonna get the traffic from, for example? Okay, so nowadays, probably your front end offers, right? They're not gonna be as strong. Means that your front end offers are just not gonna be as profitable. Okay, and so that's just an adaptation that you need to kind of swallow purely because Apple, you know, Tim Cook. Okay, so front end office is not gonna be as profitable. So, how are we gonna make more money? It's gonna be make more money on the back end, right? Okay, you might also say, okay, if Facebook's not working as well, we should diversify the traffic source as well. Okay, but when I really, really think about it, right, like what traffic source are you gonna go after? Like, there's no other advertising platform that is as mature, as advanced as Facebook. So, where are you gonna go, right? So I was thinking about you can do stuff like cross-pollinating with other people's email list. So go to an influencer, go to a key opinion leader, right? Tell them, hey, you wanna do a collaboration with the email list, okay? Content marketing, super important. Okay, content marketing, organic stuff, super important. Post on YouTube, post on LinkedIn, whatever it is, okay? Like content marketing, stuff that is like when people see the content, they want to buy from you immediately. That is the sort of content you should consistently produce. Okay, stuff that feeds value to the audience such that over time they are more willing to buy your products, basically. Okay, you want to build that relationship, that like, trust, and respect with them so that over time they buy from you. Make sense? Okay, and so once you take that piece of content, that really, really good piece of content, right? Because you're forced to go into content marketing. That content marketing, then you put it back into your paid advertising and into your Facebook ads, even though it's less effective. Okay, so instead of 1,000% just sell over the all the time, right? More value-based content is probably going to extend the LTV and build the relationship much faster at scale as well. Okay, so if you thought ads were very competitive, now it's going to be even more competitive and let per se less money is available in the market, sort of, right? Then you just got to adapt. Okay, so like I said before, let me just recap for you. Okay, email list, super important. Back end. Okay, then alternative traffic source and value building content. Okay, that's the only way I see things and how people are gonna solve this. Okay, in terms of tracking, right, I don't ever see a reality where Apple says, okay, you have the data. You know what I mean? Like we're not ever going back. We're not going back in reverse. Like, Apple's all about privacy now. So for you as the advertiser, as the entrepreneur, starting a company, wanting to grow revenue, right? I'll just admit it. Like you should be scared that Facebook is has less data now. You should be scared that there's less tracking on the apps. Okay, but that also means that in order to stay in business, you probably need to build up everything else that is essential, right? You're forced to basically do extremely good content marketing, extremely good email marketing, and always from the standpoint of providing value to the marketplace. You can't really get away with just sell all the time now. Okay, so loyalty, followings, communities, stuff like that is organic, word of mouth, right? It's more important than ever. And also ensuring that your product just flat out gets results. If your product does not get results, if it does not provide the transformation, the promise that you're giving to people, right, then it's just not going to work. Okay, it's really not going to work. Okay, so a lot of the times as well, I know a lot of the stuff we do is online. Okay, everybody's going to be online. Everything is controlled online. People are going to shop online now. Okay, so forced to adapt and just move on, right? Just move on, fix the problems, provide value to the customer, and stuff like that. Okay, this is the reality. iOS 14 is really going to affect people. Just tell you that. Because if you see like numbers across the board, right? Over time, like snap of the finger, for example, I do see revenue decrease, conversions decrease, and stuff like that. Okay, and so if you're coming to this space, like just be prepared, man. Just be prepared. Okay, like it's gonna be tough, but what are you gonna do, right? So adapt and yeah, okay, probably not the answer you're looking for, but yeah, okay, I'll see you in the next video.